Essential 8 is different in a whole variety of critical ways. There are three or four major feeder-free culture systems out there, medias out there. They all contain, on average, about 25 components. Those 25 components often do not have, or most of the time, do not have release assays or activity assays, and they are highly variable. Essential 8 is completely different because it is only 8 components, and it turns out to be the Essential 8. You can control something that's 8. It's very difficult to control something when it's 28. The other thing about stem cell media is it's not 25 components, it's 25 interactive components. If you delete one component, it affects the activity of others. The lot of one component affects the lot activity of another. Now that there's only 8, you can work really hard to control them. There's 4 biologics and really 4 chemical components. Those 4 biologics you can lock down, you can manufacture, and you can control. You can't do that when you've got uncharacterized, ill-defined things like BSA or lipids. So E8's like the stripped-down race car. It does exactly what you need it to do, and because it's so simple, you can make it in a controlled way. BSA has a pretty significant impact on the community. If you think back, why do we use BSA, right? It's a byproduct of the cattle industry. It's cheap and it's available. So it ends up being a reagent that ends up in, across all of our experiments. If you were to start over today, you probably wouldn't be isolating BSA from large-scale cattle harvesting and putting that reagent in your very delicate cell culture experiments. There is no clear test you can perform to see what the biological activity of BSA is. So you put in 1 microgram per mil of BSA, but you don't know whether that 1 microgram has the same intrinsic function as the 1 microgram you put in last week. And then you don't know what else it's carrying in with it, what other hitchhikers. It's very hard to delete it because of its activity, but once you figure out what it's interacting with and what its real job is, and you can strip that media down to 8 essential components, you don't need it anymore. The average research scientist doesn't need GMP. They don't need their research reagents to be GMP. If the manufacturer did their job and did it under GMP, it gives you, the consumer, confidence that they knew what they were doing, that it was done under a controlled process, that when you buy it on Monday and then you buy it the next Monday, different lots of that material are going to be as close to identical as possible. It's essentially the limit of science today. It's saying we're going to do our absolute best to eliminate all of that noise from your system, even though it's not necessary. Our perspective is that this is a great trend and that having GMP Essential 8 is going to be a real step forward for the field. CDI chose E8 because our mission is to manufacture every cell type in your human body and make it available in a cryo vial. To do that from many different lines on many different days and make many different tissues, you have to have a stable manufacturing platform. The Essential 8 has far fewer variables. It's a lot more straightforward. It's a lot more reproducible. And our goal, again, is if it's to make 1 billion cardiomyocytes a day, every day, and make sure they're the same, then you want that stem cell to be the same every day. And that's virtually impossible using MEFs, and it's very difficult using very complex, the state of the art that's out there today before Essential 8.